Hi, this is Kanna Babu. This is part 5 of SQL Server FAQs. In this video, we'll discuss about what are the different language commands that are available in SQL Server. So, language commands are generally used to write the SQL queries or SQL commands. There are different types of language commands that are available are DDL commands, DML commands, DRL commands, TCL commands, DCL commands. DDL represents for Data Definition Language Command. DML is abbreviated as Data Manipulation Language Commands, DRL, Data Retrieval Language Commands, TCL, Transaction Control Language Commands, DCL, Data Control Language Commands. These language commands are generally used to write the SQL queries or SQL commands. So here DDL means, here you can see create, alter, truncate as well as drop. So create command, if you want to create a database or if you want to create a table, or if you want to create a stored procedure, or if you want to create an index, or if you want to create a trigger, or if you want to create a cursor, or if you want to create anything new in SQL, we'll try to use create command. Alter command is generally used to what? If you want to do the modifications for the structure of the table, then we'll use what? Alter command. Like if you want to add a new column to the existing table, or if you want to remove the column from the table, or if you want to change the data type of the column, or if you want to change the size of the data type of the column, or if you want to modify the stored procedure, or if you want to modify a trigger, then we will mostly use what? Alter. If you want to modify a view, anything if you want to modify, use alter command. Anything if you want to create, use what? Create command. Similarly, truncate command. Truncate command is used to delete all the data, the table data, at a time. For example, if your table consists of 1000 records are there, I want to delete all the data but not the structure of the table. Just I want to delete the table data at a time. Then you will use what? Truncate. Anyway, in future we'll discuss about what is the difference between truncate and delete. Drop command, it is used to drop the database. If you want to remove the database permanently from your database, or if you want to delete the table permanently, if you want to remove anything permanently from the database or tables, or if you want to remove a column from the table, then we will use what? Drop command. So these DDL commands will work on the table structure. If you want, next DML commands. These commands are used to work with the table data. Like for example, here whenever you want to create, if you want to insert the record in the table, you can use insert command. If you want to delete the record from the table, use delete command. If you want to update the employee salary, or if you want to deposit the amount, or withdraw the amount, or if you want to update the phone number, if you want to do any modifications for the table data, then we'll use update command. So these three commands comes under DML commands, Data Manipulation Language Commands. And these commands are used to manipulate the data. Next, DRL commands, like select command. If you want to retrieve the data from the table, or if you want to retrieve a single row or single column or multiple rows or entire table, or if you want to retrieve the data based on a specific condition, I want to display all the employee details, customer details, I want to display all the employee details who are working in a specific department, then we will use select command. The name itself it is telling, select is used to retrieve the data from the table. Next, TCL commands, transaction control language commands. These commands are used to save the transaction. Transactions is nothing but a portion of work that has been done. It is a small unit of work, transaction. So there are three types of transaction commands are there. Commit, rollback as well as save point. Commit is used to save the changes permanently. Rollback is used to undo the changes. Save point is used to save the portion of transactions. And it is used to roll back the portion of transactions. Anyway, in future we'll discuss about what is the difference between commit, rollback as well as save point and how to work with that. Next one, we discuss about here DCL commands, grant and revoke. Is it clear? So, these commands are used to provide privileges for the database. Like if you want to perform any operations in the database, such as creating the tables or views or procedures, anything, if you want to give permissions to create the database or tables, or if you want to deny the permissions to create the database or tables, then we will use DCL commands. Grant as well as revoke, these two commands are used to allow and deny the permissions on the database or database objects like tables. I hope you understood. In the next video, we'll discuss some other concepts. For more videos, you can subscribe to YouTube channel and Facebook group. Thank you. Have a nice day.